Hi, second episode of today's session. Welcome back. I just resorted and wiped out some files since I ran out of disk space. Unexpectedly. Plan is to, can we get this back? Okay, so now if we mine the roof, we should be able to get lava down here everywhere, and then place another one here. That should work pretty well. Awesome. Okay, are we ready to leave actually? Maybe I wanna make sure that sleeping in the bed works and leaving the bed does not cause any damage. Okay. Video proof. Awesome. How does a video proof anything? It's so easy to fake, isn't it? I have no idea what a video should prove. Whatever. Oh, I still do get damage. What wall are you putting me in? Bro. What a nice bedroom, man. Very nice. Huh? What did I collect? Some students. Okay, so I have... Oh, I don't want to go back. I still need to find wool. That's unfortunate. So I have to go up here. Yeah, okay, come on, let's leave this boy a bit of food if he spawns here. Half a stack and then we'll refarm it now. Okay, let's leave full. Yeah, let's leave a full stack here. Okay. Can we climb up this shit? I remember this being very annoying on 2B. I think I did it once and it didn't work at all. I feel like are the TPS super good right now? Is it 15? It's working so good. I really have to put down some lava there so that it is also dangerous to come from up here. Oh no, not that thing. I have a thing. Fuck. let's go up here and then see what I can do. Oh no. Well, it's not the water update yet, is it? Wow. Life sucked before the water update. Will I get damage? Possibly, right? Wow, that was close. I really should not forget where I entered. Oh, there's a pig, let me kill that. Food! Come on! Awesome. That's so good. Okay, I got a thing. I'll be back. Shit. I hope I don't get AFK kicked. Anyways, this might be the end of this session and episode.
I forgot my e-chest. Fuck my life.
All right.
I'm back. I'm back. Let's go out of here. Okay, so what's the plan? The plan. It's to leave already, isn't it? I think so. So that's secured. And also that's secured. Oh yeah, the villager up there, that's really cool. We could trade him some coal if we wait, do another deal, and then get some diamond chest plate with what? Protection and unbreaking. That would be really cool, but it's so fucked up that a brain dead idiot forgot to take the e-chest with me. So I really have to grab the next e-chest. This far out on the highway, are there even... Oh, no. It's... No. Such a pain. Nah. Fuck, yeah. I really fucked that one up. So I lost access to all my precious e-chest items, and I can also not store items in there anymore. That's very sad. So if I'm going to build a base, will I be able to obtain, what do I need, enderpearls and blaze rods? Dude, that's just some sick stuff. Whatever. Is it even stupid to go to the Nether if you have a base, because that's a smaller world and the risk of being detected in the Nether is higher than in the overworld due to the distance? I don't know. But I feel like I want the full experience, and but I have to search a fortress to find blaze stuff, and I don't know. Oh wow. I feel like it will be a long time until I see my e-chest again. It was just such a no-brainer. Holy shit. Anyways, I guess we can get back to the highway with a bit of food in here. And we made a checkpoint, so yeah. So that's secured. Now it's very secured. I can also make it more secure by doing this, and then it will be even harder. You cannot just simply place a block to remove the lava. You have to I guess it's a bit safer like this. Okay. So if someone really wants to go down here just to destroy my bed, it will be at least a little bit annoying. Okay. I will take this boy, this boy, this boy. Okay. I mean, if I respawn here, I have the village. Should not forget about that. But I don't have a water to get up. Whatever. I will figure and survive. So I will place a lava, and then I have to refill my lava. Well, that's fine, I guess. That's not really what I expected. Okay, I can save a bit. Yeah, imagine you're in the Nether, you find a portal, and you end up here. That's a bit demotivating, I would say, right? So I hope that works. And let's get back on the highway. Oh, awesome. Oh, it's a highway. Wait, if you go in here, where do we end up? Isn't that the portal that we entered? Oh, you end up dead in that portal. Okay, that's cool, actually. So, yeah, that's cool. Yeah, no, that's cool. Awesome. I like it. I feel like I made progress. Okay. That's awesome. Back to the highway. Did I walk less than 800 blocks that I still... What's the radius? Is it 1,000 blocks? No, I thought it was like 800 blocks radius that the portal is being picked up. Wow, I really didn't walk a lot. Yeah, whatever, should be safe enough. Cool, back to the highway. What was it? Like around 3 million or something like that? 3.75 whatever million that I have to travel, so like I'm one third, less than one third in. What are we, episode almost 200? Oh wow, so it will be like... Wow, no, I can't even think about how much weight has ahead of us. I have to find a way to like improve my ability of getting distance done. Get some entity in here, ride a horse, whatever. Or was that fixed, patched? Prohibited, whatever. I don't know. I'm sure I have a saddle in my e-chest, lol. Yeah, I really gotta keep my eyes open for e-chests. To take some with me, actually. It's astonishingly how perfectly shaped this highway is. Is this made by hand or is this some automated bot who craved out this? I mean, like, wouldn't any human make a mistake and like remove a few blocks too much, especially due to the diagonal shape? It's a bit harder to, you know, properly mine it. If I were to like mine here, I would accidentally mine in another block. And like all these players traveling the highway, nobody's putting down signs anymore. There are no holes sticked in the floor. Nobody's griefing the wall. It's the shape's just so perfect. This tunnel is like someone is actively maintaining the shape of it and
making sure that it's like clean. But I doubt that. Maybe it's just not traveled very much. And maybe it's actually new, and maybe it's digged by a machine. And all the few players that traveled through here, maybe all were AFK and using baritone, and they couldn't care about, like, yeah, interacting with the environment. Interesting. Yeah, it's crazy. It's really impressive to me that this is so untouched. Yeah, like, yeah. I mean, I've played on servers, on like build servers with admins, administrated. Actually, one of the first servers I played on was a really small server with like 5 to 10 active players online, and it was, well, way before there was survival mode and stuff like that. It was like how many years ago? maybe 9 years ago, something like that. And there I can remember there already existed Word Edit and what was the other permission thing? World Guard, I think, yeah. So admins were able to protect regions so that nobody could touch them. But I think they actually didn't do it a lot because it was such a small server and it was actively moderated, so there was always some staff online interacting with all those players and monitoring them and whatever. And a lot of players were just like, I guess one of the reasons was the admins being lazy, and also maybe they wanted that the players could actually, like, there were some public, I don't want to call it highways, just public ways in the overworld near spawn that made up the infrastructure through the main city, and a lot of them were not protected, so everybody could build there. And I think the reasoning behind that might be something like everybody was trusted and people should be able to, you know, place in letters and like extend it, like it's a public space and everybody can contribute to it, right? Anyway, so it was a kind of server where some things were actually protected with WordGuard and others were not. And on there was always someone always pooped somewhere, right? It might even be a regular player, but people are just dirty. They place their blocks, they place their crafting tables, their chests, they don't clean up their mess. And well, I'm guilty myself. I was like mining ores on the main marketplace, whatever. I was digging in a hole in the floor and like was searching some iron, and the admins actually were able, what was this plugin called, so they could see who interacted with those blocks. I think that was also a reason that they didn't really protect stuff, but they traced back who edited what. So they found out that I was mining ores there, and they contacted me and were like, what the fuck, you fucking idiot, you digged a hole into the main space, the main marketplace, whatever area there. And I was like, oopsie, I didn't know. And my point kinda is, no matter how, and the server was really friendly, everybody knew everybody and it was actively moderated. It was a super friendly, peaceful build server with a very small community, and everybody was like, yeah. I mean, it's the one of the most peaceful you can get in a public server, right? With the most like most in positive intents in the player, right? And then you have this hostile anarchy environment where there's literally nothing protected. It's not moderated, and there's not even someone looking and whatever. And then there's this highway which is just shaped perfectly fine. And nobody touches it, or if it gets touched, someone repairs it, or I don't know how this shape still is shaped how it is. It's impressive. Yeah. And yeah, just like keeping that in mind, that even in a environment where there's like the common sense is to not do bad and there's no bad intent of players, things don't last if they are not technically protected. And here, where it's common sense to be as much of an asshole as you can, and where nothing is protected, and yeah, nobody touches the wall. That's just impressive. The fact that there is netherrack entities lying around, that's a bit weird to me. That feels like some netherrack was newly mined here, which doesn't make too much sense to me, because if it was mined, where are the holes of it? And if there are no holes, that means that the blocks that were mined were either replaced, then it would be weird that the blocks dropped, or that the blocks were on the highway, which could possibly mean that someone placed blocks in the way and another person cleaned them up. But then that would also be weird. That's a lot of blocks that someone placed and another person cleaned them up. Or the more, let's say, my first like idea was that the highway is like freshly mined, which I still sometimes think, because once I saw the sign at the end of the highway that said, yeah, that's the end, we will continue mining soon, whatever. But I think that was a prank. I think it was just like built some fake netherrack in there and closed, and some troll put in a sign there. I doubt that this highway is new. I mean, it doesn't have to be too new, considering that these entities would probably not go away for quite some time, since everybody who's passing through here most likely has a full inventory anyway, so the players that are like loading the chunks and walking over the entities are not collecting them due to a full inventory. And they are also not despawning, since the chunks are not loaded for a long time because everybody is just passing through. So yeah, it might be that those are still from when the tunnel was caved out and are not yet despawned. But that would mean that since this tunnel was caved out, there were not enough people loading those chunks long enough that they despawned, or not enough people with empty enough inventory passing through to collect all of those, which kinda indicates that this is a young highway. I really need some data on this crap. I'm really curious, actually. Because if it's so new, then it still might not be finished, right? I have more than 2 million blocks ahead of me on that highway, and yeah, if it's not finished, then oh boy, I really don't know what to do. I won't be able to reach the world corner if I travel in the overworld, and I for sure won't reach the corner, or like survive a day when I try to travel the Nether without a highway. It will probably almost be slower than the overworld, because I have to like go around all these lava seas, and if I try to dig, then that might actually be faster. It's still dangerous due to the lava that can be like pumped into my face, and it will take up a lot of resources to build those pickaxes. Yeah, but that's probably the fastest way, so in case it ends, I would probably dig my way, but I can't possibly dig my way through the world corner. That's just insane. Yeah, but maybe Baritone can do that for me. We will see, we will see. But I feel like there won't be any end of the highway anytime soon anyways. Maybe the highway is digged much faster than I am traveling it anyways. Yeah. I mean, even if it ends at 2 million, things will be different. If I reach 2 million, that will be like next year, or maybe in 2 years. Holy shit. Since when am I playing on the server? Boy. I might actually be playing since 1 year already. For sure I'm playing since 1 year already. So 1 million a year, that means 3 years until we reach the corner. That sounds kinda sad, actually. But hey, it's just 2 years now, right? Since we already did the first million. Wow. I really need speed hacks or some shit. This is getting boring, man. We are also another hour in, but I feel like we will be kicked soon anyways, due to like you always get kicked randomly after a few hours of playtime. So that's that.
as a block. I guess that supports the theory of someone spamming blocks and someone else cleaning them up. huh, I wish I could move on my arrow keys, because my AWSD is kinda blocked. But you can't bind multiple keys to walking, right? You can't bind multiple keys in general in Minecraft, right? It's pretty sad. Can I walk through that? Yes. Wonderful. So I'd have to rebind them and then lose AWSD. So if I'm not traveling the highway, and I need my W to walk for, it just doesn't make any sense. Yeah, that's just annoying. I just need hex. That's the only reasonable solution.
Fuck, I've run into a wall. Okay, let me readjust. Like this.
Ooh, can I jump over that one? Let's see. Easy. Better than Flappy Bird. Does it require more of my precious food? It might. That's fun.
How much time does it take to run 30,000 blocks by foot? Yeah, how long? In 30,000 blocks, I'm at 100k million. Divided by 10,000 seconds. What? 3 seconds for one block? What? No, 3 blocks per second. 10,000 seconds is how much?
I need my calculator. Divided by 60, that's 166 minutes, which is almost 3 hours. Oh no. Foxy. Oh, I can't run because I don't have food. Shit, that's bad. 3 hours is bad. Well, that's another 3 episode
productive session, isn't it? And then we have the first 10% of 2 million of the second million. Oh boy. Yeah, I feel like that's enough to be for quite some time. yeah, probably until I manage to install damn cheats. What? Only writable entities can go through portals? Doesn't that mean that the gold farms are disabled? That would be sad. I really want to build a gold farm. 70,000. No. Oh, I saw it too late. Come on, server, kick me. Yeah, okay, anyways. I'm not going to wait until the server will kick me. I really gotta get some stuff done today, and I can't really do something else than actively watch this and refood and make sure it doesn't fall down somewhere. Yeah, so this is really all the free time I have without being productive for today that I can allocate to meditate and watch the nether going by. Anyways, so I guess that's it for this today's session. Very exciting that after such a long time I managed to get back to 2B. I just watched a video of it regarding data stuff, and yeah, it was kind of motivating to see how many players. Well, it was kind of obvious, but it still was kind of motivating to see that the majority of players just joins once and then rage quits. And yeah, I usually, if I persuade something, I pretty often have a good idea how things are before actually doing them, if you understand what I mean. So when I joined 2B, I kind of knew what was expecting me and how I was going to enjoy it or not, to a certain degree. And I'm not the type of person to casually try out things. I really like going the full way and persisting, and I'm also kind of proud of that. I don't know if you can be, but I am, and FitMC's video kind of pushed me, so I would love to, you know, climb the ranking of being an active player. Like, considering the stats, what was this one stat he mentioned, that only 1% of the players played longer than 170 hours or something like that. So this is almost episode 200, and episodes can be from around 10 seconds to, I guess, maximum 2 hours or something like that. But on average, I would say an episode is what, maybe 40 minutes. So I think I already have around 170 hours of playtime, which makes me the most active 1% on the server, which sounds more impressive than it is, because you gotta consider the fact that this data was only collected during the last year or two maximum, which means that during that time I was in the 1%, but all time, like, there are players that played for many years, that would probably affect the stats a bit. But also the stats, like, I wouldn't consider, like, if you think about it, like, being the 1% of the most active players on the server sounds like I'm part of the active players, but I wouldn't consider myself an active player by no means at all. I'm very casually checking in. But there are just so many players that join once and never again. Maybe even tons of players who join once, go AFK in the queue, and get AFK kicked before they can actually play, and then they don't try it again. So it's just cool to be to kind of stick around here. I don't know. But as cool as it is that I checked in, and as much as I myself appreciate it, without Hex traveling the highway, I can only do that for so long without getting impatient and wanting to do some active stuff. So that's why I'm actively going to disconnect. I don't know if this is like the first time I did that. I probably did it once already when I was like busy and I had something to do. Well, technically I have plenty of free time today, but I want to use that free time to like continue with my fucking merch conflict and stuff like that. Anyways, so thank you for watching. Who am I saying this to? Like, nobody's watching until 1 hour and 30 minutes. What the fuck? Anyways, so that's it from today's session. I will disconnect and see you next month, I guess. Or something like that. Bye. Okay, let me record me pressing the disconnect button.